Hey buddy, this is Alpha Zero at your service. I'm going to do my final review and my final thoughts on Grisaille no Kijitsu. In other words, it's called Le Fruit de la Grisaille and the Fruit of Grisaille. Now, this episode, has a ways of finishing things, but that ending right there. Now, things are just going to get a little hectic. And what I'm going to tell you guys right now is what's going to come. Like, really, it's gonna get a little crazy. So let's just get started. Well, not too crazy, but what I'm gonna tell you about later during this review and my final thoughts and so forth, it's gonna get nuts. After that, yeah. Let's go. Okay, at the beginning, we see too that Amane ends up digging up a grave or something of Kazuki, and she ends up reading a letter, and Kazuki's request is that, knowing that I'm the one that saved your life, you're thinking in tears or something like that. I'm going to tell you right now that take care of my little brother. He's a crybaby. He's kind of weak and so forth, but he's my only brother, little brother I ever have, you know? So please take care of him and so forth. So, yeah, which is pretty nice and understandable. And then they end up visiting the grave of a bus or something, of where the others have died. And there was a sign walk here to get to the highway, and if it takes about 3 hours or something. But this is they did not know of that yet. They did not know of that fully yet, so that's another thing. Another thing what the letter says, all the students die from the toxic meat or something. As for you, you did not die since you didn't touch it or anything, you know? And so forth. So that's how all the students died and so forth, you know? And I just go, dang, that's gotta stinking hurt. And after that, Amane and Yuji was about to get going, and then they get a cell phone call, and that guy, that creepy guy, that's like one of the student's father, is like, hey, where have you been? You know, your friends are gonna die if you don't show up. I'm like, what? You know, I did not see this one coming, to be honest with you. Well, I did kind of, but I did not think it would be at a school, and I go like, what the heck, man? Are you serious? And then so forth. So I just go like, wow, dude, this is not cool or where I'm standing at right now. So as the episode progresses, Yuji calls his company for backup, and JB's like, hey, can't we just call the police? And then Yuji's like, yeah, but Yumiko will be noticed that she is alive, but she's dead, that kind of thing. So that'll be a problem. So therefore, everybody ends up working together, and Yuji says he could snipe someone very, very far away. And I go like, that's very far for a sniper. How can you even do that? Well, I'm not really sure how sniping works, you know. Even I don't know how guns work. I don't even know what's the maximum length for a guy to shoot far, you know. But Yuji's gun is a freaking crazy sniper thing. But Amane realizes what Yuji's work is. It's to clean up or something and get rid of some things, you know, and so forth. So yeah. After that, Yuji does a Morse code to one of the people he trained. Makina. He did a Morse code to Makina since she knows what's up. And later, It managed to work. They had to break the right euro whatsoever, you know, that kind of thing, and so forth. And therefore, it's Amane's turn, you know. He gets a call from the crazy punk, crazy student's father, you know, that kind of thing. And later, they end up managing to work this out. He managed to get to the restroom while Amane's gone with him, but not before he started to physically hurt her and abuse her, you know, that kind of thing. As he goes like, you sacrificed your friends to survive, blah, blah, blah. I'm not thinking in my mind, dude, doc, leave her alone, dude. I was thinking of that at first. And later, after Amane gives him the water as usually told Amane to do, and so forth, blah, blah, blah. Doesn't really matter now. And so on. So we see to it that it finally worked, you know. Yuji sniped him from the shoulder, and he managed to get out. Amane gets out of the cuffs that she is in, and later managed to get out, blah blah blah. Takes the shotgun and gets everyone to safety, And Yuji, on the other hand, calls the principal, you know, and says, this is my school after all, you know? And then it goes back to 1 year, which is kind of surprising, and it shows some guy with a goatee and then his other assistant, like, doing bazooka launches or something. I actually know who the guy is because, like, yeah, and it ends right there. After the credits, there's a bunch of quotes and previews going on and on and on and on, and I'm thinking about mine. I can't read all that, and then, like, multiple talking or something. And it ends with the quote of Yuji probably saying that, maybe I want to try and go become an ordinary student. But I think there's another quote too that says, hello, girl. Oh, you're a boy? And it ends right there. And it says, like, the Labyrinth, the Grisaya, and the other Grisaya kind of thing. But yeah. If y'all don't know, if y'all just saw that or something, then you know what's up, you know? Because I actually want to let you all know with some updates and so forth, but kind of gotten busy and kind of gotten lazy, which is stupid to me, which is a stupid excuse and so forth. I actually read some of these news before I watched Log Horizon yesterday. That's the reason why Log Horizon 2, that episode review came up a little bit late, because I read some news from a certain website or something, you know. I'll let you all know that there's going to be a sequel of Kusaya no Kujitsu, and the ending shows it, I'm not going to lie. And honestly, they say like there's going to be a 60-minute episode or something about here and there, and then like it might go into the concluding trilogy of Grisaya. And I'm going, really, man? Like, literally, yeah. So yeah, I'll get to more of the news facts later. But right now, let me tell you guys my final thoughts. Honestly, like, this episode was pretty okay, you know. If it followed the route, then that's fine, you know. But another thing that bothered me a lot is like in this series, you know, there's been a lot of rushing, you know. There's been too much. The pacing was just wrong, like literally wrong. I'm just gonna be honest with you. The characters could have better backstories and development, but not much really happened. But I'm looking forward to that probably they might make that up into the sequel or something like that or so, you know. And there was a quote saying we don't get to know more about Yuji's past or something. I'm looking forward to that, to be honest with you. But another thing I'd like to say right now is like I'm gonna have to give the series a 5 out of 10. I let y'all know I had it like a 2 to a 4, to be honest with you, a 2 to a 4 out of 10 on this series. But due to Amani's backstory, which is pretty much the best past or backstory I've ever seen out of all the heroines I've seen, Amani's backstory was one of the best, I believe. Despite it being disturbing and so forth, I think I find it probably one of the best I've ever found so far, you know, and so forth. Just being honest and literal, you know. So this sequel whatsoever is supposed to come out in spring, I believe. But things are going to get a little hectic from now on because I did do some research on it, and I'm not going to tell you guys because it's only going to spoil you, and I'm pretty sure you all know that I'm trying to be spoiler-free as possible. Like, once it's revealed, I'll reveal it. So, yeah. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to its sequel. Speaking of the sequel, I did find this in my anime list. They did mention it, and then I tried to get to anime, and I took a look at Anime News Network and so forth, and yeah. So, I don't know what to expect right now, but things are just going to get a little hectic and crazy right now. So, if anything else, I'm going to end my review right here and my final thoughts and final review, you know. Those of you who kept up with me, despite me being a little salty or something, in other words, like icky, me being the ticky, Mickey, picky guy, you know, yeah. Thank you for watching my reviews and so forth. I mean, it's been a crazy ride. So, if anything else, I'm going to end it right here, and if anything else, I'll have the links about the sequel and so forth down in the description box below. I'll try to get it working as possible and so forth. So if anything else, I'll end it here. I'm Alpha Zero people. Have a good day, and I'll see you on my next video, right? Later. Peace out. Bye-bye.